We came down here to talk about tax reform, and we want to talk about tax reform, but it's been a little bit difficult because of all the developments out of the White House and what's been going on. Is this just distracting Congress at this point, to the point we're not going to get to tax reform or health care?
Well, I think we've had chaos and confusion since this administration's been in place, and I think that has upset an agenda. But we are having our first hearing on tax reform tomorrow in the Ways and Means Committee. So that will probably give us the first indication on whether or not we'll be able to move forward. I think what's critical is that we have to have tax reform that supports middle-class families and small businesses, and we have to have something that's bipartisan. It's not going to move forward or be long-lived if we don't have a bipartisan process.
Before we get to that hearing, which I do want to talk about, there is this talk about a special counsel. From your point of view, is there any alternative to that? Is there any other way to get to the bottom of this and put it behind us one way or the other?
Well, I think the most critical thing is that an investigation needs to be independent. And so an independent commission, which is something that Democrats have called for, an independent counsel, the key word is it needs to be independent so we can get to the bottom of things, we can get facts, and we don't feel like there's influence from the administration on the investigation.
So let's turn to these hearings you're going to start having just tomorrow, House Ways and Means on tax reform. We've had Chairman Brady on, who said that it has to be, for example, revenue neutral because he wants a permanent, long-term set of tax reforms. Do you agree with that? Do you agree that it needs to be revenue neutral?
I think it needs to be revenue neutral. Clearly, that seems in opposition to what we've heard from the administration. Their plan has not been net revenue neutral, far from it. So it's unclear whether or not the administration and the chairman and House Republicans are on the same page.
So how could you get to revenue neutral as a practical and really have substantial tax reform and, let's be honest, tax cuts? Because that's a lot of revenue to come up with.
Well, that's why we need to have hearings, and this needs to be a detailed discussion. We should be sitting down and bringing in experts and talking about what's working in our tax code, what's not working, how we're going to address important issues, like making sure that we're supporting middle-class families across our country, making sure that we're addressing things we agree on, like the challenges we have with incentives for inversions or money being parked overseas. These are issues that we need to jointly address. So let's bring in experts, let's talk about what's working, what's not working, and the changes we can make. And is it a challenge because it's a difficult problem? Absolutely. But in 1986, people came together, worked hard, and we had something that came out of the Senate Finance Committee with unanimous support in a bipartisan fashion. I think that's what we should look at in terms of the goal we should have with looking at tax reform in this Congress.
We don't have a detailed plan from the president right now about what he's proposing. We do have an outline, and included in the outline is a very substantial, I think, doubling of the standard deduction. That would help middle-class families. Is that something that you could support?
Well, I think the concern on the president's proposal has been that the majority of benefits go to the wealthiest Americans. This isn't about supporting the middle class and making sure that we support small businesses and innovation. So really, and we have a one-page outline from
right.
The administration. We need details. We need to talk about exactly how things would work so that we really understand the impact of any particular tax proposal. But our priority should be making sure that we're supporting middle-class families, working families, making sure we're supporting jobs across our country, and addressing the issues that we have that we need to address with corporate tax reform.
But would a substantial increase in the standard deduction help middle-class families? Just that one part of the outline, just
that
one
piece.
Well,
when we talk about, deductions, the question is in terms of families, sometimes they're not itemizing or taking all the deductions that wealthier families are having. So, again, the specifics are going to be very, very important when we're looking at the proposals that are out there and the details that will be behind them when we get more of those details.
And finally, Congresswoman, you said middle-class families are important to have jobs. Can you agree with the administration and some of the Republican leadership that the primary goal here should be growth? Because if we can grow the economy, that will create jobs and that will help middle-class families.
I think supporting small businesses, we have a tax code that's incredibly complex, making sure that if you're a small business, so you don't have the tax counsel on staff that can help you with that complexity. So you usually don't get to take advantage of things that larger corporations do. Same's true of families. Middle-class families don't have the accountants and attorneys who are working on taxes that wealthier families might have. So we need to focus on making sure that we have a tax code that supports and allows for, you know, growth that supports middle-class families and jobs there, that allows small businesses to grow and to thrive. That's going to be critically important in any plan for it to have bipartisan support and to move forward.